You probably don't know me.
I don't know you.
I'm from Jacksonville. I have 6 children. We moved out here to come to a nice area to raise children. We brought some property in the O'Brien area, and we're raising an organic farm where we raise livestock in an organic fashion, and we're trying to make a living in that way. We have some great neighbors, and you know, we're in a really kind of a great area. Well, it turns out that my story is taking a tragic turn. One of the proposed compressor station sites is less than 2,000 feet from my front door. I'm going to be downwind from the site. My 6 children. My neighbor to my north is only 1,500 feet. He has 8 children and a 9th on the way. My other neighbor, just to the west of him, Harms Ranch to the east, has 8 children as well. There's 23 children amongst us, and less than half a mile away from this compressor station website. The incendiary range of this site in case of evacuation is a half mile. This site is in Suwannee County. We have a volunteer fire department. Who's going to respond? That's a real interesting question. The other problem I have is with the compressor station. It's going to be powered by the gas on the line. It's underneath the power line easement. That's interesting. Okay. The problem with that is the station up in Pennsylvania, there was a study done actually in New York about gas-powered compressors where they don't use electricity, they use gas. They emit things like formaldehyde into the air. They did a study on a small station, only within a half mile, people were impacted. Okay, we have 23 children less than a half mile away. It's a significant risk. You know, this is a for-profit venture. These guys are just gonna sit in here, make a profit, and I have risk, significant risk. I have to look at my children every day. I don't have the means to just go buy land somewhere else to leave this. You know, this is just silly. I mean, the risk that we have to the aquifer, the risk to our water, the direct risk I'm gonna have to my air, what I breathe every day. I'm downwind from this. And I'm gonna have to assume that it's safe because they say it's safe, but it can't, because I know it's not. I mean, I'm into organic farming. I mean, I do that for a reason, because I don't trust and believe what people say is safe and what they don't say is safe, you know. I research hard, I look into things, I do my own research, and I'm going to do that. I've already done water tests on our property, we're going to do air quality tests, and we're going to continue to do that. If this project moves forward, I'm going to continue doing that, and if there's any deviation, it's going to be a lot of litigation, and I'll use every means possible. The gentleman here said I probably won't go anywhere with it, and he's probably right. Because they don't care about me. They don't care about my family. They don't care about my neighbors. We're just here and we're going to be at risk. And I just don't see how this is in any way a right thing. And that's, if it's not already apparent, I'm strongly opposed to this. And I wish y'all guys to perhaps reconsider this process and maybe think about what we all have to risk here and what's at loss. I mean, I'm going to be a face of someone that's going to be in a specific high-risk area, you know, more than just the water supply, which is hugely important, but I'm talking about life. An incident at this plant, which they say may never happen, could kill my family. Literally. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Number 20.